different companies have different filing statuses based on the U.S. securities laws, and those designations do have some significant implications. So, for example, the timing of when a company is required to file documents with the SEC is dictated by filing status. So, accelerated filer is a publicly held company that has certain characteristics. Principally, it's a publicly held company that has public float of between $75 million and $700 million. Now, a large accelerated filer is a publicly held company with public float of greater than $700 million. Companies that qualify as an accelerated filer or large accelerated filer are required to have their internal controls over financial reporting, or ICFR as it's affectionately known, annually attested to by an auditor. In May of 2019, the SEC issued a proposal to change the definitions of accelerated filer and large accelerated filers. The proposal would essentially exclude from the definition of accelerated filer and large accelerated filer those companies that qualified as a smaller reporting company and had less than $100 million in revenue. So it would exclude from the requirement to have an independent attestation of ICFR those lower revenue companies. Now, I want to be clear, the requirement for management to have internal controls over financial reporting is not impacted by this proposal at all. What this would do was essentially shrink the population of companies that would be required to have that independent attestation of their ICFR. The SEC's intent with this proposal was to promote capital formation, which is a key pillar in their three-pronged mission. And we as a public company auditing profession generally support capital formation as a critical component to high-functioning capital markets. We do have some concerns about whether this proposal will achieve the intended objectives by the SEC. We believe that having auditor involvement in ICFR protects investors and promotes fair, orderly, and efficient markets. Smaller companies tend to be more susceptible to having problems in their ICFR. And so having the auditor involved in these types of companies benefits both companies and investors. Establishing strong processes and controls that are tested by a third party positions a company to be able to provide sustained quality financial information to the markets.